What is up, you guys? Welcome back to the channel, you guys. In today's video, I'm going to simply just kind of be educating, be bringing value and kind of just shooting the shit, kind of just speaking with a brand new real estate agent, just got her license not too long ago, a young real estate agent, right? Someone that's really coming into the business and industry for the first time. I don't know her background just yet, which we'll find out as far as like, you know, family, maybe our close friends coming from real estate or whatever. We'll see what led her into the industry, but I'm going to be kind of just going over just consulting and advice and recommendations when it comes to just social media marketing and really building a local brand. So if you guys are real estate agents, whether you're new or you're veterans, been in the industry for a while, social media marketing, Facebook advertising. At this point, I've spoken to thousands of real estate agents in this country on this topic, right? 99% miss the basics when it comes to capturing leads and building an effective brand on social media. When it comes to running Facebook ads, running local ads to capture leads, 99% miss these basics. And this is kind of where I found my whole niche is educating people and bringing value and going over the most important basics when it comes to branding and really what it takes. So I'm going to be speaking with Marissa. Shout out to Marissa. I think she's with Keller Williams, but I'm going to kind of just look at her pages. We'll look at her personal page. We'll look at her business page, and I'll kind of just give her advice on what she can, you know, update, you know, facelifts to the page, what links should be there. And we'll kind of just go into it and hopefully this video brings value to you guys. So let me bring her aboard. Give me 1 second. Hey, Marissa. Hello, hello, hello.
Okay, there we go.
There we go. How you doing?
Hi, I'm doing really good. Nice to meet you. Thank
you so much for coming out. Yes, for sure. Thank you for taking the time. Just wanted to reach out and see if I can kind of just bring some value and you know, kind of maybe give you my 2 cents on this whole social media marketing thing.
I would love that. I am a new agent and yes. I need all the help I can get.
Yes, and I'll kind of just cut your learning curve in half and kind of just save you a ton of time, headache, and even marketing, you know, budget when it comes down to this stuff. And it really just comes down to just my past and I've been in marketing forever, but it really, what I'm going to show you are just basics that I see every single agent. And I'm talking about the thousands and where it kind of all started was in 2016. Mm-hmm. When I left mortgages, I spent 6 years from 2010 to 2016 in mortgages. So that's kind of how I know your side of the business very well. It's because I was a lender. But when I left mortgages in 2016, my whole thing was I wanted to start consulting agents on social media marketing. And so to do that, I came over here to my personal page and I started removing all of my real friends and family because you only get 5,000. I literally started removing the real ones that I know, putting them on my Instagram because my whole strategy here was to fill up 5,000 with agents. And that's what I did. That started in 2016. So if you can imagine, I'll unfriend a few will unfriend me. It's no big deal. The only one who's not an agent out of the 5,000 is my wife. So she's the only one on this 5,000 list. And there's a reason why I'm showing you this. There's a reason why I'm telling you this. But this is 5,000 agents. So where it really comes from is seeing what thousands of agents are doing and what thousands are not doing, what thousands of pages look like, and what's missing from thousands of pages when it comes to our brand, when it comes to capturing leads. So it's kind of, that's kind of what my whole claim to fame has been. It was showing people, okay, here's what everyone's doing. And here's kind of what you want to do instead, you know? And so that's what I started realizing, started seeing and experiencing, just following thousands of people who all have the same job and seeing how everyone's doing the same thing. So it really starts here. It starts on this personal page. And then I'm going to pull up your business page as well. What's your business page?
It's Marissa Moeller. And then it's like KW. Let me just double check here.
Let me see if I can find it in pages right here to the left pages. So if I click on that, okay, there we go. So are you running ads? What do you got going on? Like, are you running ads? Are you posting every day on this page? What are you doing?
I try to post, like I try to have a marketing plan and then just make a post, even if it's not some super complicated thing, just for content.
So then are you building a nationwide brand or are you kind of just focused in on a few zip codes? or what?
I am from South Dakota, and mm-hmm. I'm in Sioux Falls, if you mm-hmm. are familiar with that area. And that's kind of where I'm at, is
awesome.
In like Sioux Falls, Mitchell, Madison, kind of in that area. And that's where I'm starting out at.
Yeah, exactly. For sure.
Experience. Like, this is the first thing I've ever done career-wise, per se.
Man, you're coming in at such a young age, and that's so amazing, man. My hat goes off to you. Like, I'm really, really impressed. What brought you into the industry?
Trying to start young, so that way when I'm older,
yeah,
I kind of have my a leg up, you know?
Definitely. Definitely. So again, the reason why I start off by normally saying where this knowledge is coming from these 5,000 friends who are all agents, mm-hmm. that right there is so, so important to know that I'm not here to just show you some bluff or some fluff. It's actually based on what the market and what the industry is really doing. And sure. So what most are trying to do is, yes, build this local area. But here's what ends up happening. As you scale this friend count, and it's the same for every platform. So with you being younger, social media for sure is all you know, right? So now mm-hmm. as you build your brand on social media and pick your platform, they're all the same. When it comes to this friend count, majority of these people will not live in that area. So they won't be down the street at all. There'll be people like me who are in a completely different state across the country, and maybe even in a different country. As you build your Instagram, as you build your TikTok, these are people that are from India, you know, a few mm-hmm. people that will come across your pages, right? So here's the problem, is that as we take this friend count up, we're attracting people from all over the place. Therefore, this information is irrelevant.
Mm-hmm.
That's social media marketing. So what everyone's doing is they're rushing to every platform to put out content, when your dream client is not globally or even nationally. Your dream client's in your backyard.
Mm-hmm.
That's why Facebook ads and Instagram ads is so, so important. So I'll just make that clear. If you don't learn anything on today's call, learn that I'm recommending you should learn Facebook ads. You absolutely have to learn Facebook and Instagram ads. Because with that, the same exact post could have been targeted. It could have been shown to my neighbors. It could have been shown to my town of where I'm trying to show my face. That's where it could have been shown, right? Mm-hmm. If it was an actual ad. But because we posted organically, I'm just saying that most of these people, whether it's on this platform or Instagram or TikTok, most of them are not even in that area.
Yes.
So posting organically is kind of a waste of time, but it does start here on this personal page. And even on the business page, it's even a waste of time. And it's a waste of time on for two reasons on the business page. Reason number one is because the 258, they came from us clicking invite to the 2000.
Mm-hmm.
But what David is saying is that 99% of the 2000 don't live in your area. They don't even live in your state.
Mm-hmm.
Nor do they even care to. No disrespect, but you don't care to live in California, sure. Right? So if I was a local, in even more local, San Diego inside of California, if I was a local realtor, but really farming San Diego, Marissa doesn't care about that listing. Marissa doesn't care about that open house at all, mm-hmm. especially if you weren't even a real estate agent. If you were just a normal consumer, you don't care at all. So mm-hmm. as you're friends with this person, this is what's going on. So we're inviting these friends to like the business page. Problem number one is that those people, the majority of the 258, again, will live out of the state. That's problem number one. Problem number two is that when you post, Facebook only shows it to 1% of the like count anyways.
Oh,
so that's okay. Why you'll notice these posts won't get much engagement. Unless it's mm-hmm. you sharing it, and the video would get more engagement than an image, but the images, you won't see much engagement at all. Now mm-hmm. this is more general. So you would think that there'd be engagement because it's a cute bird. You would think there'd be a little bit more, but the moment there's market information, the moment there's a listing or an open house, you won't see any engagement at all.
Mm-hmm.
Because again, Facebook can only show it to 1%, but again, that number, they're not even in the state. There are people like David who are across the country.
Yeah.
So the real estate information is not going to be relevant at all. That's organic. That's mm-hmm. organic. And that's what every agent's doing. That's what every business owner is doing. And if they're local, I'm just saying that's not the strategy. That's not the strategy. So here's what you want to do though. But here's the basic branding. And here's what I call step one. Here's basic branding. And this is what I see by the thousands, every agent on my friend list. this intro is kind of where everything starts, right? This intro. And on the business page, it's this about section. So this is step one. This is as basic as it gets. This is step one. And what I'm going to show you here again, this is what everyone's looks like. Let me show you an example of what I'm recommending on what you should add. And all this is a simple little facelift, simple little edit, super basic, super simple, but it makes all the difference. This is, again, yours. This is what every agent's will look like, the intro. You have broker associate at, and then you have maybe any former or past, and then maybe pronounces maybe followed. But the problem here is that not only is, yeah, there's a ton of stuff missing, which I'll show you, but the one that's actually included is not even our business page. That's our brokers. So yeah. As you, right? So problem number one, and I see it all the time. It's not just you, it's everyone. The 2000 friends, those who are not in the industry, they have no clue. They're not reps. They're not title. They're not escrow. They're not lenders, right? They're nowhere in the industry. They're not agents. For the 2000 that are just average working class Americans, right? Citizens or whatever, they have no clue that this is not your page, right? So you're driving a good amount of traffic to this page. People are liking that page, thinking they're liking yours, thinking they're following you, right?
Sure.
Okay. So simple edit, taking out that link, and it needs to be this business page link, right? It needs to be your link. It needs to be the link to your business page. Simple. And then also what's missing on the personal page in the intro are your social media links. So again, that first one is your business page. Down here, rather than having restaurant pronounces and followed, that will still show up in the about section. So if I click on about, I'm going to see restaurant under work and education, but it doesn't need to be in my face in the intro. What needs to be in my face in the intro is a link to your business page. And then also your social media links. That's what is going on over here. So here's my friend Candy. She's an agent. I think she's with Keller Williams as well. She's in North Carolina. This is her personal page. As I come to her page and I scroll down just a bit, here's her intro. So right away, there's a link to her business page, not her brokers. And then we see Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, LinkedIn, her website address, which she doesn't have a full-blown website. She just owns the .com. And if you look closely, which you don't even have to look close, each one is identical. Basic branding, right? Instagram.com / hedge properties, TikTok.com/ hedge properties, Twitter.com/ hedge properties, right? So all she did is she simply created an account, an active account, customized each name and listed it. Simple. Like, this is so basic, but I'm telling you, everyone misses it. And I just think in your business of real estate or any small business owner for that matter, branding is everything. This is basic social media branding, customizing the links and listing them. So that would, I just think that looks a little better than having it blank. You know what I mean? Right. Do you see the difference? I mean, is there?
I do. Yes.
Right. For sure. And then also, and the reason why it starts here on the personal page is because this is where you're connecting with everybody. It's not the business page first. You're not sharing your business page with random people. You're connecting with them as friends. And then, yeah, maybe you'll click invite, right? And even if I met you locally, if we were at a luncheon, you know, let's say I was a lender, you're an agent, we're all meeting up to network, I give you my business card, we're going to connect here before I even bring up my business page. We're connecting as friends, right? Mm-hmm. So that's why this page is important, because this is where it starts. This is where any relationship, offline or online, it starts on the personal page. And the only reason why the business page is even necessary, and this is a fact, the only reason why this page is even necessary is if you're running ads. If you're running Facebook ads, if you're running Instagram ads, that's what this page is for. Every business owner wants to have one thinking that it's important. No, it's not. Because the organic post is not reaching the right audience anyways. Those likes are people all across the country anyways. So this page, I might as well just post on my personal page, especially if all the likes are my friends on my personal page anyways. Right? Because these posts on the personal page, these get more reach and more engagement than this post would have been on the business page. Sure. If that makes sense.
Say that one more time.
The post that we put on our personal page gets more engagement, and it's shown to all of our friends, versus if I took that same post and simply posted on the business page. If I would have took that same video and posted it here, not shared it, I'm talking about giving it its own space, posting it here separately, it would have got more engagement on the personal page because I have my 2,000 friends over here and Facebook's shown it to all of them versus the 258 that are also the 2,000. They're also part of the 2,000 because we clicked invite, but Facebook has only shown it to 1%. Right?
Okay.
That's the organic post on a business page. So it would have done just as good on the personal page. But again, the business page is for ads. But when it comes to the links, that's what we're kind of talking about is the links, the personal page, and then over here on the business page. So over here in the about section on your business page, right here, you have your KW link, you have your email, but we're missing everything else. We're missing LinkedIn, we're missing TikTok, we're missing Twitter, we're missing Pinterest. And even if you don't even use all these other platforms, what you do want to understand and always keep in mind is where your audience is at. If you're in real estate now, let's say you're going after sellers. Sellers are for sure over the age of 25.
Mm-hmm.
Not many sellers are 19, 20, right? Maybe first-time homebuyers, but not sellers, right? Like these are homeowners that are freaking old. So for sure, that demographics, they're on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, LinkedIn, and Twitter. That's what you see over here on Candy's page. You see Facebook, you see Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest, and LinkedIn. So all I'm saying in this case is you don't have to post on all these platforms because that's what I'm trying to tell you not to do. It's not about posting for everyone to see. It's about running ads, targeting your local area. But this is just something you want to update for the hell of it. Like just update this part because this part makes a huge difference. You don't have to be using all these platforms. Just get it listed. Activate it, customize the username, and get it listed. And then over here on Candy's business page, so here's her business page. Here are the links. So as I scroll down on her business page, right here on the left-hand side, there are the custom links. So there's her .com. There's her email. There's Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, Pinterest. So that looks much better than, again, having everything blank, right?
Sure.
That's what I call step one. Here's step two, three, four, and five, and then that's all I got for you. Here's step two. When it comes to this like count, here's what you want to also keep in mind is that, yes, you're brand new. Yes, you just got your license not too long ago. And yes, you're for sure young. But no one cares. No one cares for one. That's a good thing. No one cares. But at the same time, no one knows that either, right? No one knows that. So when I come across a page, what I'm trying to tell you is that this like count, this is step two. Now the like ad, that's how you and I even got here. This like ad. If you can imagine, and again, the whole reason why I even showed you the 5,000 friends is just to kind of have you imagine what I've seen, how many pages I've seen, and the fact that they're all agents. When it comes to step two, the like ad, here are my notifications. So Marissa is not the only one clicking invite. Like every single agent, Christy, Jeanette, Carrie, Janice, these are all my friends. These are my notifications all day, every day. It's all I get is an agent clicking invite to get me to like their page. When I go to the page and the first thing that just sticks out like a sore thumb is the like number. On Instagram, it's the follower count. Right? Maybe even on TikTok, you're looking at someone's followers, right? Like that's why this matters. This is the follower count, the like number, right? So if you can imagine, I've seen thousands and thousands, tens of thousands of Facebook business pages. 99.9% have anywhere from 200 to 300 likes. When I land here, that's what I see, 258. When I land on Candy's page, let me just give you an example, going back to her business page, just showing you the basic impression that people get right away. So if I go to, let me go to her business page. So if I go to her business page and I scroll down just a bit, that's what I see.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know Marissa. I don't know Candy. I don't know John. I don't know Jeremy. I look at a stupid number and I automatically assume this person's crushing it. Little do I know she's young. Little do I know she just got licensed.
Mm-hmm.
I care. I mean, I don't care either, but at the same time, little do I know that I don't know. Like, right. So if I come to your page and I see a few thousand, automatically you have that credibility. That's why the like ad is so important. Like that's the first ad you want to put out. So before you try to capture leads or run lead ads, because that's a whole nother story. That's a whole nother call. And the reason why it's a whole nother story is because there's a ton of setup that goes on before you run a lead ad, a Facebook lead ad. But in this case, this is a simple like ad. Like this takes one couple buttons and you run a like ad. But that's your first ad. That's your first ad is you want to simply take, and you don't need to go that high. Like I'm telling you right now, every agent has 200 to 300. So you don't necessarily need 3,500, but you for sure want to put a comma, take the 258 to 1200, right? Take it to put a comma in it quick. And it happens through a Facebook ad. So that's what you want to do first is get your links up. Think of that one name that you want to brand. Also get the .com for it. And you don't need a full-blown website. You can continue to use Keller Williams, this website that they give you. Just own the .com. Don't brand this .kw. Like, don't brand this link. The public doesn't need to see that link. The public needs to see marissamoeller.com. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, or whatever. Like, for example, on the business page, you did a good job. You already customized this one. This is what I'm talking about. Pinterest, Instagram, LinkedIn, same thing for all them. Just simply customize the name. So you went with a name that I don't recommend, and I'm going to try to convince you to change it because you don't want KW in it. That's the only reason why. So you went with Marissa Moeller KW, which is cool, but chances are you may not retire there. That's just the fact. Like you may be somewhere else in a few years. So the last thing I want to do is put them in my branding. So if anything, you know, Marissa Moeller or Moeller Properties, or something catchy, something short and catchy where that becomes your branded name. And so all I'm saying is,
I've always thought MBM Real Estate.
I love it. I love it. It starts with checking if the .com is available, right? So you go to what I do. I recommend GoDaddy. That's where I get all my domains from. They're like 10 bucks a year, but give it to me again. What is it?
MBM Real Estate.
Mary, Bob, Mary.
Yes.
Okay. Real Estate. .com. Okay. So mbmrealestate.com. Search, see if it's even available. See, so it's taken. See, that's what led me to teaching this step, because you could have had that name already taken on Facebook. You have it on Facebook, right? You could have had it on Facebook, but the moment you go and check LinkedIn or check if the .com is available, it's taken. So if you can imagine how many times I've seen that happen to somebody and they're like, holy shit, David, that's my name. What do you mean they have it? Yeah, dude, someone freaking has it. Like you didn't customize them all in all. You only took Facebook. You should have took LinkedIn as well. You should have did all of them. You should have got the .com, right? So that's what led me to kind of stress this, the importance of this, you know, because this is our brand. This is our name. I need to own it on every platform and the .com. So, and again, real quick on the .com, you don't need a full-blown website. You just need the .com, and you can brand that .com. And when people click on it, then it forwards to your Keller Williams. That's simple settings in the domain settings. When you purchase the domain, you can have it forward to wherever, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
But you're branding your name. So that's kind of where I would start. Just get that one name and you don't have to post on all these platforms. Again, I'm trying to convince you to just run ads, but have the platform active, have the name customized and have it listed. Because as you build out your Facebook and as you continue to connect with people here and you do these amazing videos here, as this friend count goes up, then you for sure want to be able to lead them to different platforms. All the connections may come here, but who knows? That person that connected with Marissa here, that person probably spends more time on TikTok. Had you had your link for TikTok listed, that person would have clicked on it and followed you there. And because that's where they're comfortable messaging, they would have messaged you there and you would have been glad you got that message, right? Simply because it was listed.
So right? It's not like if I have a TikTok, it's not like I necessarily have to post on it every day or something. Exactly. I just need to have it so that if people like that better, they can communicate with me through it.
Yes, exactly. Just because a person can see it. Oh, she's on Twitter. Hey, let me message her there.
Yeah, that makes sense. I've never thought of it like that.
It's that and the branding aspect. The branding, the fact that that's my name and everything is customized, that looks better for my brand. It's also that too. But most importantly, yes, so people can communicate with you and people can find you on their favorite platform, not just yours. Right. Mm-hmm. And so I would start there. Start with your links. I have a YouTube video that I'll send you that walks you through all that of linking everything. And then the like ad, is there any budget? Like, I know you're new, but do you have any marketing budget set aside yet at all or not?
Not really, to be honest with you.
Yeah, for sure. I get it. So get your feet wet, start getting something in motion, right? And then whenever you do come back to Facebook ads, reach out to me and I'll help you run this like ad. And simply taking this to just, again, putting a comma, and that's kind of just ad number one. And then you just move into learning how to run these ads for leads. Like, this video should be ran as an ad targeting that area and getting thousands of people to view it.
Well, okay. So when I did this video, I had already, like, I went to the store, I filmed it, and then mm-hmm. I set the parameters for like, comment, share. But what I should have done, which my marketing specialist told me after I already shot the video, was to create a landing page, and then they would fill out all their contact information, which then would be automatically updated into my database.
Yes.
So, and I will do this again with a different business. I want to do it like monthly.
Mm-hmm.
And so then that'll be like what I do next time. Be like, oh, instead of saying like, comment, share, it'll be like, just go click this link to fill out this contact information. It'll automatically be entered into win.
Okay. So here's the deal. That's one strategy, getting people to opt in for some type of drawing. Yes, that's for sure. That's a strategy. That's a marketing strategy that works for sure. In your case, what I would do is I would talk about whatever the topic is. So if it's crystals, incense, home decor, if that's the topic, okay, cool. That's the topic. But I'm also real estate, and that's kind of really why I'm even doing the damn video, because I'm also in real estate. And so what I would also add to that is putting out some type of free PDF. So for example, I would focus on the real estate side. I would focus on one topic, either buyers or sellers. And so let me just make it simple. Let me ask you, what fires you up, buyers or sellers?
Sellers for sure.
Okay. Sellers. Okay. So that's what I'm saying. That's the topic. So if this was me doing the video, I would say, okay, guys, hey, in today's video, I'm talking about love crystals, incense, home decor. And then I'd go on my, what is it? 36. What did you put 1 minute and 21 seconds. When it hit 110, I would have probably been closing it up. At 110, here's what I would have said. Hey guys, and by the way, and I would have brought up my real estate, right? Hey, and by the way, you guys, I put together a free PDF. I put together a 2022 seller's guide. So if you guys are homeowners and you guys are interested in what it takes to sell in today's market, I know a lot of people have questions. I'm dealing with clients every single day. This is what I do. I put together a 2022 seller's guide that gives you the top 10 ways to increase the value of your home before selling. I like to give it to you guys for free. So if you click learn more, so it's not send message, it's click learn more. So again, this is going on in the last 10 seconds. Hey guys, click learn more. It'll take you straight to my page where you can download your free copy. That's it. So now every piece of content I put out, I could be video, I could be interviewing a local business owner. I could be at a local business, whatever the topic is, whatever. I'm talking about the call to action. If that was an ad, if that was targeting that local area, the call to action would have been to download my free seller's guide. It's not email me. It's not call me. It's not comment below. It's not, hey, enter to win. It's really just, it's really all about your seller guide. It's all about giving
value. You're adding value to yourself.
Yes. You're adding value for sure. You're adding value. And that's kind of what you're doing here. You're giving people value on love crystals, incense, and home decor. And that can be the topic for sure. That could be exactly who Marissa is. And that's what you want to do. That's what marketing, that's what a lot of people fail to do. They fail to integrate the real them. If you're into love crystals, incense, and home decor, and you happen to be a real estate agent as well, and this type of content fires you up, keep doing it. Because on the back end, you're going to build a brand, but on the back end, you're actually going to find people who want to do real estate as well. Mm-hmm. That person happens to love crystals, incense, and home decor as well. That's how you attracted them. They just happen to be a homeowner. they happen to keep you top of mind and you end up listing their house in 2 years from now.
Yeah.
That happens with building this personal brand. But what I'm saying is the call to action should be, yeah, if that's the topic, keep talking about that. And then the real estate topic is sellers, giveaway, a free PDF, giveaway, a seller's guide. That's the icing on the cake. And that's sure. where I'll end it. That's what it's all about, is that landing page. Yes, your marketing team, whatever, whoever's putting that together, that needs to be a simple landing page pertaining to a seller guide. And let me show you a basic example. Here's a basic page. So your marketing team can for sure put together 10 simple tips. So again, we're narrowing in the focus. We're not talking about everything real estate related anymore. We're talking about selling, what it takes to sell. And if I were you, if that really fires you up, I would make all of that, make selling all of your content. Now, in this case, I'm talking specific Facebook advertising, running an ad, targeting your local area, and getting people to download your free seller guide. But this is also a strategy that you can implement on all of your content from this day forward. Talk about one topic. And at the end of that one topic, that post, that piece of content, there's also a link that gets people to download your seller guide. That's how you sure. capture leads. So people either love tips or they love mistakes to avoid. 10 simple tips to raise the value of your home, or 7 mistakes to avoid before you sell your home, or 7 mistakes to avoid before you hire a real estate agent. And maybe it's a 3-page PDF where you're giving your freaking 2 cents on what that consists of. Sure. That's value. So value is content. Yes, that's value for sure. But the back end is getting them to click and enter their name and email. And over here, I'm not asking for phone number. Over here, it's not a full-blown interview form. No, over here, click the button, enter your name and email. That's it. I don't need phone number right now. I'm not going for a phone number right now. I'm going for a name and email. I'm going the non-aggressive route, right? Just give me your email. And then on the back end, your email automation is what pushes that email out, right? The moment they opt in, that button's clicked, they come to a second page, but on the back end, automatically that email would have went out, which would have allowed me in this 45-second video to say thank you. So for example, this is just an image, but this is the video and this is where I'll end it. As leads come in, they land on this second page. So to your marketing department, this is called a thank you page. So they know the landing page. That's what they're building, is your landing page. This is the second page, what we call a thank you page. This is your money page. Because mm-hmm. here's what happens. As that lead opts in, they then land on this thank you page. And now I'm going to have a video there. Hey guys, this is David. Thank you so much for downloading my 2022 seller's guide. In this seller's guide, I give you the top 10 ways to increase the value of your home before selling. My name is David. I'm with Keller Williams Realty. Here's a little bit about me and why I'm so fired up to help people in the greater area of San Diego sell their property. So here, all I'm doing, 45-second video on my cell phone. All I'm doing is I'm thanking them. Thank you for downloading my seller guide. Number 2, I'm introducing myself. Number 3, I'm saying, hey guys, and by the way, I just emailed your PDF. So if you check your inbox, you'll see it there. It's titled Your 2022 Seller's Guide.
Sure.
Right. So I'm telling them that in this video, hey, I just emailed, go check your inbox. Sometimes it lands in spam, but I just emailed it. And then number 4, again, in this 45-second video on my cell phone, number 4 is I'm saying, hey guys, and by the way, if you guys are in the market, if you're a homeowner and just need questions answered, I'd love to speak to you. So if you click the button below, it'll take you straight to my calendar where you can schedule your best time. That's it. So 100% of my effort is going into putting this post through a Facebook ad targeting my local area. Yes, educating them on love crystals, incense, and home decor, but also having a call to action, because this is all about my real estate business, really. I'm clicking and they're downloading my seller guide. That's how I'm able to integrate it all. I can go interview local business owners. Hey guys, and by the way, I put together, that'd be the last 10 seconds.
Yeah.
Right? I'll interview the local dentist, local yoga instructor, whatever. Last 10 seconds. Hey guys, and by the way, I specialize in helping homeowners sell. I put together this free seller guide that I'd love to give you. Click learn more. It'll take you straight to my page where you can download your free copy.
Sure.
So now your entire marketing evolves around giving this free copy away. That's it. That's the only piece of content, whether it's organic, whether it's an ad, whatever. It's all about getting people to download my free seller guide. That's it.
I see. Where did you learn all this stuff?
I've just been doing it forever. I've just been doing it since I was probably your age. I've been doing it. I'm probably double your age. I've been doing this since I was, 19, 20, just got into marketing, first year of college, got into the internet. That's when the internet was first starting to scale. Mm-hmm. There was no high speed. It was just internet connect to your home phone line at home, right? It was just a computer, a cell phone type of stuff, right? That's when I started learning the internet. And I didn't learn.
I do have a question.
Yeah, for sure.
Is there a class that I can take that would educate me more about this kind of stuff? Like, how do I learn more about what you're saying?
Yeah, that's you can YouTube. Like, again, I have a YouTube channel. Like, I've been putting out this content since I started teaching agents, which was in 2017. So I put out weekly videos every Monday and Thursday on YouTube on all the stuff.
I'll be following you.
What's that?
I said, I will be following you.
And see, that's my link. So again, back to step one, listing all of your links. Here's my personal page. That's my link. So I got the .com, right? I don't have a full-blown website. I just have my .com that matches all the platforms. But when you click on my .com, it takes you straight to my YouTube channel. So you could subscribe that way by just simply clicking on my link. But a ton of ways. Yeah. I mean, I have videos forever and then YouTube, there's so many different coaches, but that's what I do. Also, I coach real estate agents on how to run Facebook ads, but you may not be there. Like as far as budget just yet, like if you don't even have a budget for ads just yet, then you may not need coaching at this time. Maybe get your business going first. Right. And then allocate a little bit and put a little bit aside for learning this stuff. Don't jump into ads right away like most do. Actually hire a coach to teach you how to run these ads first, whether it's a course, whether it's a one-on-one coaching, whatever. But Facebook,
I have a lot of resources like that in my company.
What's that?
I said I do have resources in my company that they can teach me more about this stuff too.
Yes, like a lot of times, and I know you guys have Command. So a lot of times there's a whole Command department where they just run the ad for you. But I'm saying learn it. Like I'm saying actually learn how to do this stuff yourself, not just sending it to
reliant on someone else.
Yeah. Like that's where the budget should go. The budget should go into coaching and mentoring first on how to do this. And then you go start putting money towards ads. Everyone does it the other way around. They go put ads, they go put out money and blow their money. And then they don't ever want to do it again. So hire a coach first and then learn it. But that should be 2022. That should be your number one priority when it comes to marketing your real estate business, is learning Facebook ads, Instagram ads, which are really the same thing. It's all ran through Facebook. But the reason for it, and the reason why I continue to just simply be an advocate of it, is because if you're a local business owner, that's how I can target my local area. Bottom line. If you're nationwide, then do what you're doing on social and post 7 times a day, every darn day. But you're not building nationwide. You're kind of building locally. You're building even more locally, which is probably 2 zip codes.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So it's like, man, why not show my post in front of that audience? That's why Facebook ads. And everyone, don't let your broker teach you all this offline stuff. It's just not there no more, man. It's not there no more. So, but stay in touch, because that's what I do. I coach on doing all this stuff. So stay in touch, get your business going. And then I would say maybe do the links. And then whenever anything opens up, reach out and let me run this like ad for you, because you're not going to run it the right way at all. So whenever you're ready for this one ad, I can for sure help you with that. And maybe just give me a good review.
Okay.
That should be the first, that should be like the first couple hundred, like your first couple $100 we need to put at this Facebook ad, let it run for 30 days, take the $258 to $1,200 bottom line. And that's like a couple hundred.
I can only do that.
Well, let's maybe do that then.
A day, but
what's that?
I can budget for, I need like $100 to $200 to do this.
Yeah. To run this one ad, I'd say throw $200 at it. Let me run it for 30 days and that would blow up that number. That's your first ad. And then you have all your links listed. Now your page looks good. And in the meantime, you're getting your business going. And that's when you start freeing up more budget to learn how to run these local ads to capture leads. The like ad, that's not a lead ad. That's why I help agents with that. That's a one-time ad. You'll never run that ad again. It's all about learning how to run these local ads to capture leads. That's my coaching program. So that's kind of down the line. So do we have a budget for an ad for the like ad now?
Like today, I could not afford to just throw $200 at.
Yeah, whenever. Reach out to me whenever. This is just our first and next ad is the like ad.
Okay. I will plan for that.
Yes. So what I'll do is I'll send you a video here when we're done. That will at least help you link everything, like get all your links listed, right? Figure out that one name. And then after that, let's stay in touch. And then we'll run the like ad and then get into coaching way after that.
Okay.
Cool. All right, Marissa. Thank you so much. And you owe me a good review. I'm going to give you one too.
I will.
You know how to do that?
I do.
Okay. Awesome. I'm going to give you one too. So stay in touch.
All right. Thank you. Okay,
thanks. Take care. Bye-bye.
You do.